Hello everyone, and welcome to another episode in my Let's Play series of Custom Chips Challenge 2 level sets. This is Joshua Bone. Today I have just downloaded the latest version of Flareon 1 by Josh L., also known as Flareon 350, I think, on CC Zone. This is version 1.91, and there are 55 levels. This is not completely a blind play. I think a year and a half ago or something, I did a playthrough. I don't think there were 55 levels at that time, but I think that a number of them are probably levels that I have played before, but it has been a while as well. So to those who don't know Josh L., he is a very experienced level designer. He's done all sorts of levels for the Chips Challenge 1 community. And he pumps out quite a few. I think he's up, I don't know how many levels he has, like 400 or 500 or something like that. But he's pretty well known as a consistent quality level designer. And so I am looking forward to playing through his set. Without further ado, the first level is known as Poison Backyard, and this is a level that I think I've played before. And as I recall, yeah, I think I actually did a full-on level review of this level by itself. And if I recall, it's pretty good. So let's see what we can do here. We start out on the slime. This is a 10 by 10 level, as I recall. So that block there is a clone machine underneath the 1K flag. Looks like there's only one way to start the level. We knew that was a clone machine. Okay, this yellow key looks like maybe the next thing to get. Nice timing there. If you hit it just wrong, the fourth floor will send you left into the water. But the yellow door is kind of inaccessible right now. I can do this and access over here. I'm just gonna, yeah, there's only one yellow door in the level, so that's fine. There is a transmogrifier up there, which would help with these ice squares. Because right now I can't turn that ice block around. Let's just try doing this. I can push this guy straight up. And now I can push the ice block around. Oh, but that, I was not expecting that. I thought for sure that was going to be a fair square. Well, let's see. What else can I do? There is this recessed wall here. Push that block straight up and over the red key, but then there's fire in the way. This block here, I can push down or up. And, again, I'm not looking at the time limit on some of these, so it's a fairly short time limit as well. Really interesting design with the slime everywhere. Don't see too many slime levels, I feel like. There's also that ladies only sign, which I can go through now. But there's gravel blocking me if I do that. Okay, that was a little bit of hidden information. Did not know there was a green key under there. But, you know, on a level this size, hidden information is, I think, pretty fair game. Oh, that's right, I don't have boots. So one possibility would be trying to ice block to the fire. No, it's water. And then if there is there a way to get either of these blocks? It certainly doesn't look like there's a good way to get a block up there. Right, because even if I push this block up, I'm not going to be able to do anything with it. That clone machine. Whoops, I stepped on the recessed wall. That's okay. I don't think I'm going to solve this level this time. But okay, I've been making a little bit of progress, I feel like. Oops. You know, for a 10 by 10 level, this is pretty freaking awesome. Oh, that's also a wall. Okay. And this is a wall. That's the key I was missing. Okay. That gives me gravel boots, but wait, what can I do with that? Feel like I'm getting closer, but I feel like I'm also not quite there yet. Can I clear this way? I can, although that was probably dumb. Getting close. And then, yeah, so this is the key that I wasn't seeing before. Get those boots, but I block off exit that way. That's all right, because I think I need the red key to exit. Now I have both blocks. Okay. Could turn into Melinda. Oh, come on. That was I just stepped up into the bouncing ball one square early. I was getting excited. Sorry. What did I do last time? And then now I can push this guy up and over, and I can exit. And then if I wanted to, I can also get the 1K bonus, which really wasn't that hard. And so that's Poison Backyard. Awesome little level. I love the 10 by 10 thing. I do wonder if the recessed wall was necessary for anything, but I feel like I used everything else pretty well. Never had to use the clone button again, so I'm not sure why the clone machine there is there, unless it's just for kind of a, you know, to add a little bit to the confusion of the elements there. But I really love just, you know, the sequence of things. I really love just figuring out things. The key under the block, ordinarily I kind of don't like that thing, but I thought it worked here awesomely, just because of the shortness of the level. You're just trying to figure out what else to do. You push that block, and there's the next step of the level. So really good job in Poison Backyard. Next one is called Green Apple Harvest. So Chip starts on some gravel. Looks like there's a glider path. Can't get the red key yet. And there are a bunch of green toggle walls, and or toggle chips, rather. And there's the red key. Okay, and so now I get to push that block into the gliders, and that will start toggling these guys. Ah! And it's funny because it looks like a lot of monster dodging, but the trip around is actually quite easy. So grab the key, come up here. And really it's just, I think, a matter of patience. Oh boy. Why was that? I'm wondering if there's different ways to kind of to get that toggling thing going. I'm not sure it's entirely equal. There might be more time spent on one toggle state than the other. Yeah, it looks like there is. I'm wondering, I'm just trying to figure out if there's different ways to. To split these up. They seem pretty close together now. Well, that was interesting. Okay, so that gives me plenty of time. But that might not be enough for... That might be perfect. It's an interesting little arrangement there. The time limit is pretty short, and that's probably the biggest thing that I'm worried about here. Especially because in here, those first chips at least, the time is kind of wasted, but then you got plenty of time when there's more chips like on these. I think I've got enough time. I'm assuming that all the green walls are real walls. look how there's bonuses here. So that was Green Apple Harvest. Decent level. I think the collecting of green chips is a little bit repetitive just because each room at the corner is exactly the same as all the others. And so, there is kind of the feeling of like, all right, if I can do something once, I can do it four times. But it wasn't, that's a minor complaint. It's a pretty decent level. It's fun getting the bonuses at the end. And actually, it was kind of cool finding a pattern for the toggle button that was even, because the other way you had to remember, like, is this a short press of the button or a long press of the button? But it's a legit level. It earns its place in the set, I think. The aesthetics are nice. I like the symmetry, I like the color. So the next level is called Block Tug, and there are all these. I'm guessing there's a hook somewhere. There is. And there's a transmogrifier. Ah. So you get to push all, or yeah, tug all the blocks out of the way. Presumably you get to pull them to the transmogrifier to turn them into ice blocks to get bonuses everywhere. This is shaping up to be pretty simple, yet using the hook tool to good use. Actually, I really like the I really like using the hook tool in this like big open thing where it's not actually that much of a puzzle. So I'm guessing that the exit is under here. I mean, it has to be. And then so it's just a simple matter of this part looks maybe a little bit repetitive, but. Just bridging across here. I do like the aesthetic with all the gravel, and then that's a pretty clever place to put the end, I think. Especially, I really like times where in a custom Chips Challenge 2 level set you use a mechanic that would have been impossible in the previous game, and this is one of those. Like if you had I can't even remember if that's a valid tile or not, but if you had an exit. Oh, no, of course it is. It was used in. I feel like it was used in the last level of the main Chips Challenge 1 set somewhere, but an exit covered up by a block is pretty cool. Is it? An exit covered up by a block that's in a corner and cannot be pushed is even cooler. Oh, I get to meet Belinda. Wouldn't be able to get very far with all the gravel. Also worth noting that if you make any ice in that corridor, the level should be impossible to solve, because if you try to pull a block over ice, it catches up and kills you. There it is, the exit. Yeah, so that's a Block Tug, and it's a great little level. I like how it looks when you first set it up. You got all those squares of dirt blocks and squares of walls, and you can't do anything until you find the hook. Opening the doors to collect the key. It's just a very unique level. And then the final push to the exit, maybe a tiny bit repetitive, but totally cool all the same. Very fun to play. Next up is Minions. I think I remember this level. Okay, so we've got the exit blocked by a chip door or a fire square. I'm guessing there's no fire boots in the level. And then there's this trap that's held down by this button. Over here we have three pink buttons and four bombs guarding the way. And then we've got three chips in the level. Also a very short time limit, it looks like. So three chips guarded by bombs. And then there is the doppelganger clone, which is a very unusual thing. However, okay, so this is an interesting mechanism. If you clone, or if you press this button, it clones a fire or a pink ball down in the corner there. The pink ball will press a red clone button, which presumably will clone, that clones the doppelganger. And then it'll hit one of these four bombs. But then if you make too many of them, then that will clone a fireball, which looks like it'll come through the fire, go up here, hit the fire again, turn around, come up here, follow this path down here. And so maybe that's not a problem. But maybe the more fireballs you create, the more dangerous it gets, and eventually you end up with fireballs going up and hitting into those pink things. Actually, I think when I remember when I played this a year ago or so, I think that my solution just involved just absolutely spamming tons of these doppelgangers. And so maybe, I don't remember whether the level's been changed since then, but it could be that that's designed to prevent me from doing that. However, because I like to have fun sometimes, you wouldn't know it from my droning voice, but I'm just gonna... Yeah, so that doesn't work nearly as well as maybe it once did. So maybe the level has been fixed actually to make that you actually have to do it the right way, which I don't think is a very difficult level anyway. So that's just fine. Could be wrong. Always open to. Oh come on, don't waste one. All right, so now all the chips are there. And we're going to end up with at least one fireball in the level because I drowned the one doppelganger. But I think that the level is forgiving. Oh, no. So it looks like... Oh, that's the purpose of this railroad track here, is the pink ball goes up there and it just goes back and forth on those buttons. And so it creates an endless stream of fireballs. So really, you shouldn't drown a doppelganger. Don't be like me. Do my bidding, minions. Sacrifice yourself so that I may collect chips. That'll do it. That is a fun level. Just very simple, and honestly, I could see making it a bigger level, and maybe even finding other ways to sacrifice the minions. I could see making this a full size level and having like different places where maybe one minion has to step on a toggle door for you, and one, you get where I'm going with it. Just having all sorts of different jobs for the minions. And of course, them all presumably dying in horrible ways. But this level is awesome. very restrained use of the concept, but I love the mechanism on the right. I love the endless stream of fireballs that occurs if you make too many minions. That's a pretty, and it's a creative. You could very easily make a mechanism that only gave you four minions. You put a tank cloner and four spaces for the tanks to pile up on while they go over the clone button, and then so you get four uses and no more. But this is kind of cool because I feel like you could probably still solve the level if you made too many and got that endless stream of fireballs. So, pretty cool Next up is Temple Bypass. Got a ring of dirt around a ring of blocks, and there is a red key underneath one of them, which, if collected, will prevent pushing a block down through here. Oh, come on. And so I'm wondering if that red key will require a block slap to get through it or not. And if it does, that brings up a question that I've kind of long had about whether a block slap is considered fair game for solving a level. We'll see if it does. And I think it's a very debatable concept. In the CC1 design world, block slapping is only possible in the Link's rule set. So most people are designing levels for both rule sets, and so you never make anything that requires a block slap. But in this case, if I push that over and collect that red key, then I have no way of pushing it to this final water level. Except, no. Okay, no. So this is perfectly fair. Perfectly fair, because one thing that I could do is block slap that. But I don't need to because I can just collect the red key, exchange it for the blue key, get the fire boots, and now I can fill in that last water square no problem. So that is perfectly fair, and I appreciate that too. I am curious to know what other people think about the whole validity of using block slapping in the level. But anyways, right here, I have a feeling I may need to come around and grab those fire boots again. All right, so there are chips underneath ice blocks here. That's a required first move, and now I can see the whole puzzle. If I do something like this, then do I need? Oh, 'cause, yeah. So here's what I'm gonna do. Is I'm gonna leave some fire there. I grab the yellow key, and so this is why it's nice to leave boots on the elements before them. 'Cause now a really cool bonus. I really like this mechanism. So now I got the bonus, and I have the fire boots too. The block puzzle is very simple. The time, I just noticed, though, is short. So I don't know if I'll beat it the first try because I'm kind of being methodical about things. So I have the helmet. And all chips are taken care of. And so now the question is, how do I toggle the green door? Okay, so it's straight up above the green. I just got to send it north through the toggle wall. And so I think I press this first, and then I press this, and it's open. So that's freaking awesome. One thing I like too is that I think that, there was a times two bonus at the end of that first bonus room. So if I really wanted to get the maximum score, after that toggle door was open, I could collect the 100 bonus and go back and get that times two. So Temple Bypass is a super easy level. I don't necessarily understand the title of it, but it's totally cool. Pretty easy, and I'm glad that that first room was fair and didn't require an actual block on it. Okay, so this says you cannot stop the timer until you get the chip to the left of you. And so the timer there is 600. And as soon as I open this green door, it's going to start counting. So just to give myself all the time, I'm going to restart here, go through the teleport. I got the hook and the green boots now. Interesting idea here. So, oh, interesting. So now, I wonder if I can pull something off the. Okay, it looks like I cannot pull something off of a movie. Ah, that was dumb. But I can push, and I'm hoping I can. Whew! Oh man, the hook. What is the proper way to do this? I almost wonder if I don't want the hook for this. Because it turns out you can press or you can push dirt blocks with directional blocks. Another idea is to just time it right one at a time. I don't have to get all four moving on the slide. Hoping I don't die here. Rare use of stopwatches, free bonuses. I don't think I'll need the tools again, but it never hurts to drop them before a thief. Okay, so this guy has to go to this square. This guy has to go to this square. Ooh. Red key opens this. This guy to here. This guy to here. Grab the fire boots. And I wonder how to get the bonus. I wonder if there's a little blue wall maze to the bonus. I like that. That's a really cool little part of the level there. I don't know what the blue door is for. Interesting directional block puzzle, and I'm trying to figure out what the point is. Okay, so it looks like I need to clear the way with directional blocks. Push the dirt block over to the black button, open the door, and then push this guy all the way through. Interesting that there's fire here. I have the fire boots, so it's okay. And then I wonder if. Right, because those destroy themselves in fire. Push this here. Is this as easy as it looks? Grab some bonuses. Two blue keys. Oh, that was dumb. Why did I jump on the railroad again? All right, so there's one. And I'm assuming too. There's a key thief, which I don't see the point then of picking up the yellow key at all, unless you can get to the other side and grab the green boots. So up here we got a bribe, that's the point of it. So excellent use of Chip's challenge two elements. Yeah, so this will go nice. Nice. Okay, so that was a pretty cool use of green teleports and walls. And then I need to make it so that I can open all of these, and it doesn't look too bad at all. So nice, easy puzzles on this. Nice, easy puzzles, but like the point is that they very, very they do an amazing job of demonstrating all the new elements in Chip's Challenge 2. Okay, so okay, what's going on here? Okay, so this looks pretty simple. I can grab the yellow key. That's a nice touch, you know? Like, just say that the direction is blocked on this, but you know, but then it's super easy to yeah, it's not a difficult puzzle at all, but it's nice to just, you know, to add that little touch. And so I got plenty of time on that little timer. I've actually got more time there than I think I have on the time limit. So that's actually, I think I made the same point the first time I played it, if I recall. Which is like, what's the point of having this? So this timer here that this ball's been counting down will close off access to the exit. So this, I think, was the same complaint that I had about this level before, is what's the point of having a secondary timer that has less time than the actual time limit on the level? It's a very interesting idea. It's a very interesting idea, but in this case, it's kind of like, well, if you have two hard set time limits, which will either will result in you not passing the level. In this case, like it doesn't add anything to the level other than maybe just a little bit of interest in logic circuits, but it doesn't add anything gameplay wise. But other than that, this was a very fun level with a series of very easy puzzles, but very appropriate puzzles for early levels in a set. And excellent, again, I will say excellent use in this set of using the Chip's Challenge 2 elements. All right, Marine Science Museum by Josh Lee. Okay, so blue wall puzzle. There is an opening up there, and it looks like, are there four rooms? I think so. Everything's looking very, very blue. And there are a lot of things going on inside these puzzles. Okay, so there's the exit, and to get to the exit, you need keys of all four colors, as well as all the chips. And I wonder if there's an order that these puzzles need to be played in or not. All right, so if anyone's wondering, this right here is a well-known bug in Chip's Challenge 2, which causes weird behavior with the no item sign. So in that case, the blue wall never actually disappears. But okay, so we've got a fireball here. And a bomb down here with a yellow key. So I'm guessing that there's one key of each color in each of the four rooms. I can't push the ice blocks into the bomb because of the green wall. So I'm guessing, I think I see it. This is awesome. So you clone a fireball, it dies. You push the blocks over one and create ice. This is awesome. So you clone a fireball, make another water spot, push the blocks over. Eventually, eventually you'll be able to make a path for the fireball to come around and hit the bomb. So what a cool idea. And the next one should do it. All right, so the southwest room is complete. A very cool little puzzle. Let's try northwest. Looks like there's plenty of time. There's the chip. Okay, so we've got... Interesting. So this is a level that you have to... Yeah, so you push the blocks to hold down the buttons. The tank can hold down one, except for this button over here, there's two water squares to get across. So even if we used two blocks to cross over there, I don't understand how the other button gets held down. Because it certainly looks like we need all three buttons. Right, because... One block for the left, two blocks for the right. Oh, that's right, these are flame jets. So then you only have to actually press the button once. You don't have to hold them down. Okay, I got it. This would be a great case for using the 10x10 view for the window instead of the 9x9. Okay, I'm actually going to pause the level just for a second. And the recording as well. And I'm back, actually a day later, to finish up this Let's Play. But we're still in the middle of the level. Looks like the game has stayed paused overnight. So hopefully we can just pick up where we left off. And okay, so we're up here. That's right. Okay, so... This puzzle might be a little bit nicer with, I might have said it before, but with the 10x10 field of view instead of the 9x9. Because as it is, you're kind of spending a little bit too much time stepping down here for a closer look to see where the yellow tank is actually. All right, that takes care of that. We end up with the green key and some more chips. Don't need the yellow tank for anything else. So that's two out of four puzzles. Next one looks like a railroad maze. I do have flippers. Should probably check where that track goes before I jump on it. That track leads over there. That's just fine. 140 seconds left. Okay, that didn't really seem to do a lot for me. All right, so this is the other way. So now I don't get the flippers anymore. Yeah, so I want to come up here. Yep, I took the wrong exit. And now this is great because now I can't really get those. So So wait, what do I? That's right. I. Oh, interesting. So what I think I do is I leave these right here. Ha. Yeah, and then I swim around here. So this is actually like a little mini version of a level of mine called the Great Train Robbery, where you have to like figure out how to leave a boot on a set of railroad tracks at just the right intersection. Now I am running out of time, so I'm gonna stop talking here and see if I can finish the level in this go. Probably cannot. That was dumb. I should have thought about this a little more, even with the time crunch. I might be okay with the puzzle at least, but I don't think I have enough time. Well, I suppose. Alright, so there's that. That was dumb. That was dumb. I was under a time crunch. I didn't notice that extra water square. So, anyways, this is a really cool level. And now that I know kind of more or less what I need to do, it shouldn't be a problem to pass the second time around. I'll just leave that right here. I almost wonder if you could just use the ice blocks here to press the green button too and just not even use the tank. Right? Because if you did this. This, that opens the way. So I wonder if that counts as a bust. Sorry, that was up in upper left. Oops, one more. That'll do it. favorite chips, got all the keys, and plenty of time to exit. Yeah, so Marine Science Museum is a pretty sweet level. All four puzzles are pretty neat. It looks like a minor bust on the tank puzzle, but again, it's like it doesn't really save you that much time. It probably saves a little bit of time, but I like that there's multiple solutions to it. It definitely doesn't ruin the level one bit. Yeah, all the puzzles are nice. I like the fireball puzzle a lot. I like the railroad track and figure out where to drop the railroad crossing sign. Although now that I think about that, did I even need to do that? I don't know. But anyways, totally fun level. Actually, I want to, now that I said that, let me go back to it and see if I actually needed to. So the question is right here, you drop the flippers. No, see, I think I was treating the no flippers sign as a thief when I was figuring out what I was supposed to do. Because now, now you just go right back here, walk through here, pick up the flippers, and you're good. So I actually didn't need to do that. But that would have been an amazing puzzle with the thief there instead of the no flipper sign right here. The next level is called Tricks and Trade, and I think I'll make it my last level of this video. And it looks like there's a fireball here that we need to guide to the bomb. Which should be just as simple as that, right? Although, yeah. Yeah, because then that swivel door right here will be ready for us. So that wasn't bad at all. Now, there's a bowling ball and fire boots and some tanks, and there's a few different options for... So, of course, you can grab the fire boots and turn that on, whatever that does, and turn the green button on, whatever that does. Neither of which I have no idea. Okay, so that wire opens this. The green button, I don't see... Oh, it turned that into a chip, so... That was all good. And then the question is, I'm assuming that this is the answer to the puzzle. Fire that bowling ball straight up there. And that gives me a blue key. So that was pretty easy. I see the way to the yellow key. And to the yellow door, I need to go back here. Okay. And a nice area button. So, oh, and then so this chip's on the outside, which you need to make sure you can get them and get back. And then there's that green key in the middle. Cool. So these are, like, I mean, this whole set is just filled with great little puzzles that are really not too bad at all. But they just do such a really good job of playing with the CC2 elements in interesting ways. So that makes it really fun to play. And I wonder how you can get that bonus. You had boots at this point, you could drop them. So I'm assuming that I need to go through and stamp down those boots for Melinda to be able to play. Oh, because I need to get the boots as Melinda, or as Chip, rather. This is a really cool little gender maze, I guess, for lack of a better term. Yeah, that's awesome. That was dumb. I obviously need to be chipped for that. And I've got some hooks. I've got some no red key signs here, and I wonder if there are red keys underneath the blocks. There certainly are. And in order to play over here, you have to be short a red key. I guess I just have to hit these bombs. Oh, and so maybe I want to make sure that I unlock this door next in order to give myself a way to turn the blocks around. Right, because now I have a little bit more maneuverability if I still have a red key, but maybe it doesn't matter. Right. Okay, and I wonder what's underneath the last block. Green boots. And just for the fun of it, I will fill in this water. Don't know if I'll need to. Oh, well, there's the railroad crossing key, or sign, and get some bonuses now. It's a generous bonus for a tiny little backtrack. And then I lose all my tools. Interestingly, I might be able to, if I planned out right where I put them, well, no, I wouldn't be able to pick them up again because there's water underneath them anyways. But there's fire boots. And I've got this nice TNT that I've got to decide what to do with. Looks like I could use it to get the yellow key, or I could just blow up the yellow door. And then there's all these bouncy balls over here. So I definitely need to get the chips. And so what I could do is I could just blow up the yellow door and one of the no green key signs. That's probably kind of a bust. I'll blow up one of my TNTs, but I would have had to do that anyway. So. Oh, didn't think about that. Right then. back to where I started. Looks like, unfortunately, two bombs are needed to get through this area. So again, I think it's perfectly fine to do this, but I do need to remember that that walker's coming through. And so interestingly, this way actually gives me an extra yellow key, and I don't know if that'll be... It'd be interesting if that was accounted for with a bonus later on. Okay, so if I put one of them right here, that'll take care of that. Put one more right here. And here I am, there's a red key and a whole bunch of, okay, so this is a really interesting bonus mechanism here. If you're willing to take 50 seconds off the clock, which I am, can run down and get all these guys, and then we add 10 seconds to it. Get a quite a nice bonus out of that. And then we gotta drop the fire boots, change into Melinda. Tiny little blue wall and ice maze, because why not? Just using up a little bit of the level, I guess. Change back into Chip. And then... Okay, so the blue teleports, I think, means that if I mess up this section, I can get back. Not that I intend to mess it up. Although there are water boots there, so maybe that wouldn't be true. I wonder what the teleports are for in the first place. Oh, right, so there's flippers. So now if you didn't get all the chips, you would be able to just do this again. Oh, cool, So by moving the yellow tank out of the way, it gets you the blue key. And then now that you have the blue key, you have access to drive the tank over here into the bomb. That's awesome. And then that's zero chips left, and you can exit. And again, I will point out that I never got those bonuses, that's fine. I think it's really cool that I have an extra yellow key at this point. And so, like, you know, if the designer watches this, it would be totally awesome to put in a yellow door, you know, maybe over here or something that leads to some more bonuses. But yeah, that was a fun level. Really, really enjoyed it. Continuing with the theme of you know, using Chip's Challenge 2 elements in creative ways that make for fairly easy puzzles. And so the difficulty curve right now is just awesome in that it's, yeah, so far everything's pretty easy, but it's been a lot of fun to play so far. So that's the end of my first video. Thank you everyone for watching. I'm sure I'll be back either later today or tomorrow with another one. So thank you.